Welcome to the SAP Business One Inventory Management Overview Demo. Using SAP Business One, you can track your inventory in the warehouse in real time. Every inventory transaction that you add will update your inventory quantity levels, and if you are using perpetual inventory, the monetary value as well. Most companies require the ability to report their inventory situation at any time, while some companies, such as services providers, do not have the need to track inventory information at all. The inventory valuation method that you choose will help the system determine how much the item sold cost, and this is used in your cost of goods sold postings and inventory valuation reports. There are four valuation methods available in SAP: moving average, first in first out, or FIFO, standard cost, and serial or batch costing. For more details, watch the items valuation method video for an in-depth explanation. Valuation methods can be set up at a global level or item group level as defaults, but can always be set manually to override the default. Warehouses are key building blocks of your company database. If you keep inventory in stock, you have a constant need to know which items you have, how many of each, and where they are located. Knowing this helps you make better decisions in terms of fulfilling customers' orders and planning your future purchases. The warehouse in SAP represents a physical location, but can also be a virtual warehouse. For example, some companies create warehouses to represent major vendors that use consignment, or a warehouse can represent items that are in transport or even in quarantine. It is possible, and recommended, to track the cost of items by warehouse. This is helpful if you are selling the same product out of multiple physical locations where the landed cost of the product is different. Depending on the type of product you are selling, you may require bin locations to organize and manage your warehouse better. SAP allows up to four different sublevels and can be defined based on your needs, for example, aisle, column, shelf, and bin. A bin location code acts like a GPS coordinate in the warehouse and allows your warehouse team to quickly identify where to go to get an item or to put items away. Bin locations have many properties that allow you to better control the movement of your inventory. The properties include alternative sort order to help with picking paths, minimum and maximum quantity, maximum weights, item restrictions, and transaction restrictions. It is also possible to define attributes to a bin location, for example, temperature, to ensure products that need to stay cool are put in the proper bins that are temperature regulated, or picking location to identify whether a bin location is meant for overstock storage or picking. If a warehouse is bin located, you can enable features to help with auto allocation of inventory during the picking process, as well as determine receiving bin locations to aid in the receiving and put away process. The bin location content list report outlines all the bin locations that the item is in and the respective quantities. If an item is batch or serialized, you can break it down to see which serial numbers or batches are in which bins, making recalls and quarantine processes easier. A replenishment process can be run directly from the bin location content report that allows inventory to be transferred from one bin to another or from a different warehouse to ensure the minimum inventories are being maintained. The pick and pack process is an optional step in your sales and production cycle. The pick, pack, and production manager scans your open sales orders, production orders, inventory transfer requests, and reserve invoices by requested delivery date and priority. It provides a consolidated view to see which items are needed and by which date. This helps the warehouse team to allocate the inventory according to the business needs and generate pick lists, instructing your picking staff on what items to get. SAP by default allocates inventory by delivery date, but it can also be allocated by customer priority, customer code, or document number. These allocations can be modified as the business sees fit. There are three steps to the pick and pack manager. First, release pick lists. After reviewing the allocation of the inventory, select the documents that you want to release to be picked. It is possible to create one pick list from multiple documents, or you can create a one-to-one relationship. If your warehouse has been located, you can also split larger pick lists by item group, or can decide to only allocate inventory from specific levels of the warehouse. The pick list is generated and assigned to a picker to get the items. Second, updating the picked quantity. Once the pickers have completed the picks, they will update the picked quantities to reflect what they have picked. If there was an item on the pick list that could not be found, it is left as unpicked and will go back to the open drawer for picking in the future. Third, create the follow-up documents. The pick list can create a delivery, AR invoice, inventory transfer, goods receipt or goods issues, depending on the base document it was created from. This step closes the pick list and removes these lines from the pick and pack manager as they have been fulfilled. A key function to maintaining a well-running warehouse is ensuring your inventory levels are accurate. To help with this, SAP can either recommend cycle counts on a recurring basis by item and alert the user that a stock taking is required, or you can create ad hoc cycle counts. To generate a cycle count, you can select different criteria like cycle code, item group, warehouse, and even sublevels in the warehouse. The recommendation outlines the items to be counted, and an inventory counting document can be created directly from here. Once an inventory count sheet is created, it is provided to a counter to complete the item count. It is recommended to freeze the inventory while the count is in progress so that inventory isn't accidentally miscounted. The counter will update the counted quantity on the count sheet, and it will be updated. If there is a variance in the counted quantity compared to the system quantity, it will highlight it in red, and the manager will need to decide whether the variance is acceptable or if a recount is required. If the variance is acceptable and understood, the inventory count is then copied to the inventory posting to make the inventory adjustment and post the respective financial impact. This demo covers a high-level overview of the inventory functionality within SAP Business One. There are many iterations and applications for the configuration, documents, and tools discussed today. To learn more about how SAP Business One can help you manage your inventory better, visit our website at www.aclaros.com. We look forward to connecting.